Hello friends, welcome to the tutorial series on wiremock from software testing help. As part of the agenda, we will cover stubbing and stub priority and how they can be used along with JUnit test with wiremock. So let's get started. First, let's try understanding what is stub priority exactly. So stub priority is nothing but to find out an effective or the winning mapping for against a stub. That's nothing but the request that's sent to wiremock server. What this also means is for a request that's sent to wiremock server, as per the data with the stub mappings, there are more than one mappings that match with the incoming request. So in that case, tiebreaker will be used as stub priority. And this stub priority is set when the stub has been created. If at all there is no stub priority, in that case, the mapping which is added in the last or the latest mapping against a request is given precedence or priority and that is returned. So let's see how we can use along with JUnit test wiremock setup. I'll create a sample project in IntelliJ and it is nothing but a simple Maven project which has dependencies for OKHttp. And this is the REST client that we'll use to send requests to our wiremock server, then the wiremock server itself, and finally JUnit, where using which we'll be writing our test. I've created a test file called wiremock JUnit rule test, and this is nothing but a simple class file. And in order to use wiremock, you can use a concept of rule in JUnit. I'll create a wiremock rule object, and this is nothing but simply like test fixtures where you use before test, after test, things like that. What it does is before every test, it sets up the wiremock server at whatever port you have given, and at this point we have given 8080. So before running every test, it will set up wiremock at port 8080, and after that test it will kill the wiremock server. So that's how this rule works, and we can write tests which contains arrange, act and assert. In wiremock world, arrange will be to configure stubs, act will use an HTTP client. Here we are using OKHttp client, but act will use any HTTP client to basically request a particular URL. And assert will actually assert the response that was received for that particular URL. So this is a sample stub that we have. You can see that configure for stub for get, these are all static methods that are present in the wiremock library or wiremock Java bindings. Configure for is nothing but you can mention host and port here since we are running on 8080, and this stub for is the method used to stub for any particular URL. So what we are saying is stub for method type is get with URL as user slash one will return a response with body something like this. So that's how you configure stubs using JUnit test. You can also create some complex stubs, or like let's try creating a stub for say post method. Let's say configure for localhost 8080 and stub for post with URL stuff for post with URL equal to say slash users let's say, what is the response? Suppose we want to return OK with body. Okay, suppose user created. So this is again simply builder pattern. And say suppose with header content type, suppose application plain. So that's how you can configure stub, and again you can add multiple things like will return OK is again shorthand to return a response with say 200, or you can, instead of this, you can say status as 200. Again, there are a lot of ways to write it, but that's how you configure a stub here. And to use this stub, basically this wiremock, when instantiated, when we call this method here, it will essentially configure or create that stub mapping in the wiremock instance, as we have mentioned, as configured for localhost 8080. And that's how it will work. You can simply you know use this test to assert these responses. So let me say the rule test 2, and let's call this method now here. We'll use the same client with 8080/user. Method is post. Now it will require some body here. We can use form body. Suppose request body new. Again, these are all OK HTTP specific things. This will not accept anything blank, that's why we are adding some dummy post here. And let's say body is body, and let's say assert equals user created is the string. And let's try running this. Okay, it says, what's the difference here? Probably users is something that we need to hit. It did not find stub. So this is our test. Let's run this again. And we can see now this test has passed. So that's how you can create stubs in IntelliJ or your project and simply use them to do different assertions. And let's finally see the concept of stub priority here. And let's see how you can configure stubs here with priority. So as we saw with Postman example, we can again create three different stubs here with different priorities. So we had like stub for get URL equal to something, say service endpoint 1. You have to use at priority method, say at priority 1 will return say OK, and with body as endpoint 1. Similarly for endpoint 2, net priority 1 will return endpoint 2. And let's finally create the generic stub for priority 5. Get will say URL path matching or URL matching service dot star at priority 5 will return say not found or bad request, something like that. Endpoint suppose not implemented available. So that's how you can use concept of stub priority using at priority keyword here or method here. This will ensure that even if multiple stubs match, the priority will be priority or preference will be given to the one with higher priority. So that's how you can use concepts of stubs as JUnit rules in wiremock tests. Thank you.